We head to the west central part of Minnesota to view the Otter Tail Valley Railroad. Owned by Rail America, this railroad operates 71 miles of former Great Northern trackage from its headquarters in Fergus Falls to Moorhead, Minnesota. From there, the railroad operates over trackage rights to interchange with the BNSF in Dilworth, Minnesota, which is adjacent to Moorhead. Other interchanges are also done in Fargo, North Dakota. Otter Tail Valley acquired the property from the Burlington Northern and began operations in October 1986. Then the line was purchased by Rail America in 1996. Along with its daily runs serving customers along the line, the railroad also runs unit coal trains to the Hoot Lake Power Plant near Fergus Falls and shuttle grain trains from the Foxholm Branch. This railroad uses a fleet of four first-generation high-hood locomotives on track that is good for 40 miles per hour. We will follow one of the daily freights from Fergus Falls to Dilworth and back. In Fergus Falls, the XGN Depot serves as the railroad's headquarters. These tracks were once a part of the Great Northern's main line between St. Cloud and Fargo. The line from Fergus Falls east to Avon was abandoned by the OTVR in 1991 because of little online business. The last passenger train was Burlington Northern's eastbound Western Star train number 28 on May 2, 1971. One of the four locomotives sits on display outside the depot. This unit is an ex-Southern GP18 built in 1963. Our train, with two high hoods, passes the depot and begins its northwestward journey to Dilworth. The train is starting the day with six cars, but will end up with over 50 by the time it reaches Moorhead. Our lead unit is 1483. This ex-nickel plate road GP9 locomotive is still lettered for the Minnesota Northern, which Rail America owned up until August 2000 before being sold to KBN Incorporated. The current Minnesota Northern is featured in C-Vision's video Minnesota's Railroads Volume 2. The 1483 also saw service on the Dakota, Minnesota, and Eastern as well. With a 10-mile-per-hour speed limit through Fergus Falls, the trains round a curve approaching the end of the speed restriction. Up the line, the tracks run alongside Johnson Lake. The train is now clear of the speed restriction and highballs to its next stop in Rothsay. Thank you. Approaching Rothsay, the train prepares to slow so that the crew can make a pickup at the elevator. Now, at the elevator in Rothsay, the conductor removes the Fred, and the crew backs the train to pick up two empties. On the outskirts of Rothsay, there are 11 loads on the siding that the crew will pick up before leaving town. The crew just picked up the 11 additional cars in the siding, and the maintenance of way crew clears from working on the switch to let the train pass. Thank you. An old grain elevator stands next to the tracks at Lawndale. This classic-looking structure is now abandoned, but still retains the original owner's names. We are now in Barnesville. Here the crew will pick up one empty fertilizer car from the Rothsay Farmers Co-op and 10 empty tanks off a siding track. Moving down by the depot, the locomotives head down the siding track and past the old GN water tower to pick up the 10 tanks from Cargill. The Cargill plant is actually located just outside of town on the Barnesville branch, but these cars were spotted here earlier for pickup. Right next to the Barnesville station sign resides the old GN depot. No longer a part of the railroad, it now serves as a hairstyling salon. The crew has just picked up the 10 tank cars and heads to the main line switch. With its train complete, the crew heads out of Barnesville and past the old water tower. On the west side of Sabin, the crew is going to pick up 15 of these loaded hoppers. The two classic high-hood locomotives now work extra hard, pulling 55 cars for the remaining 7 miles into Moorhead. Now in Moorhead, the crew brings the train to OTV Junction. It is here that the tracks connect to the BNSF. The crew will pull the train onto the main line and shove its train a short distance to the yard in Dilworth. The OTVR train is now heading into the west end of the yard in Dilworth to make its interchange. It will take quite some time for the interchange to take place because of congestion and yard movements, so we elect to take this time to view several BNSF moves while we wait for the OTVR train to make its return trip. We are set up right next to the 21st Street overpass in Moorhead. A loaded coal train is next, and is quickly followed by a loaded westbound grain train, which will be stopped here for a red signal. Before the grain train departs, we notice this classic ex-Chicago and Northwestern grain hopper showing its age. 3.5 hours have passed since the Otter Tail Valley train arrived here in Dilworth. With its interchange now complete, the train shoves back to OTV Junction to begin its homeward trek. However, the major delay in Dilworth has taken a toll on the crew's hours of service, and the train will only make it to Barnesville as the crew still must switch the Moorhead Industrial Park. Now, on home rails, the train passes OTV Junction in Moorhead. Our lead unit is now 192. This is another ex-Southern GP18, like the one on display by the depot in Fergus Falls. Approaching the Moorhead station sign, the crew slowly brings the train to a stop before making its way back into the industrial park. Relocating our camera within the industrial park complex, we watch as the crew makes a set out and pick up of some hopper cars and center beams loaded with drywall supply. With only a short time left, the crew highballs at maximum speed to Barnesville. The train rounds the curve into Barnesville as the sun is just about to set. It will come to a stop at the junction of the branch line, and the crew will tie the train up and head back to Fergus Falls in a taxi. This brings our show to an end. We hope you enjoyed our tour of the Minnesota Southern and Otter Tail Valley. These two railroads live up to the standards of classic Minnesota short lines and provide reliable service to the customers they serve.